Welcome to the first meeting of session six of the Citizen Participation and Public Petitions Committee. I am Bill Kidd, MSP for Glasgow and East Land, and as I'm told, oldest member of the committee, I have the pleasure of convening this meeting for the first two items of business. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome all members, and I look forward to working with these colleagues on this committee. Well, before we move to the first item on the agenda, I'd like to remind everyone to present to switch mobile phones to silent if you haven't already done so. Now, no apologies have been received, so we're all on board here today. And agenda item one is declarations of interest. And the first agenda item is for each of us to declare any interests we have that are relevant to the work of the committee. Background information is provided in the declaration of interest paper. So firstly, I have to state that I have no relevant interests to declare. So now I'm going to invite my colleagues to make their declarations. And firstly, Jackson Carlow, can you make your declaration, please?
Yes, I can confirm that I have no relevant interests to declare.
Thank you very much, Jackson. That's Jackson Carlow. Paul Sweeney, please.
Thanks, Chair. I have no relevant interests to declare. Thanks.
Thank you, Paul. That's Paul Sweeney. David Torrance, please.
Declare.
Thank you, David. It's David Torrance.
Relevant interest to declare.
Right, also. So that's all members. And item two is the choice of convening of this committee. The committee's task is to convene on paper two. The parliament of the Scottish Conservative and Unionist Party are eligible for nomination party's nominee, and can I ask Carlo for the post?
I'd like to formally
very much indeed, Tess. Okay. And I am now vacating this chair for MSP convener.
Bill, and can I just conveners of this committee to Stuart, all of whom I had the pleasure of working with in different committee, having served on it, and I think inherent to that is the free-flowing exchange of views and forward and do our very best on behalf of the petitioners whose petitions we will be considering. So I'm we have no idea petitions that are outstanding as a consequence the deadline for which petitions Parliament, even though some were still being tabled. But what new work will come in the months ahead? Ask into working with colleagues. The next item, agenda item three, and the Parliament has agreed that only members of the Scottish National Party are, and I believe David Torrance will be the nominee, and therefore I'm very happy to convener of the committee.
And have great pleasure in nominating David Torrance as
and therefore, David, you are duly elected our deputy convener, and I know you are the continuing member of this committee. Be previously on it, like it feels 100 years ago now, but certainly experience to bear in and to the benefit of all of us. So congratulations on your.
Thank you, convener, and I look forward to working with my colleagues. Forward, as you say, we don't know what's going to come our way, so it'll be very interesting. And as long as we could highlight the good work that the committee does, I think it's really important. And as you say, this is now my third session on the Public Petitions Committee, so I'm really looking forward to it.
Thanks, David, and welcome to all of the other members of the committee as well. To it turns out is older than me, to Paul and to Tess. So I hope we have a successful session ahead. Our fourth item this morning is to consider the work programme in outline terms, and there are two or three decisions that I think it would be useful for us to take. Consider holding a business planning session. There'll be an opportunity at that for us to consider the legacy report, just to consider and agree, you know, our statement of intent for the committee in the months ahead and the Parliament ahead, and also to discuss all the other relevant issues that we might wish to consider in terms of the way we will take forward the work of the committee. So I'd very much like to propose that we agree to the holding of a planning session during the summer recess, and that, all being equal, that we aim to do this in person here in the Parliament at some point, probably in the final week of the recess. Does that meet with the agreement of the committee?
Yes.
Well, I won't call it division, just because we know from experience that can then take half an hour. So I'll take it that was generally agreed. And as a matter of course, the second item that we have before us is to consider the status of 15 petitions that the predecessor committee had referred to subject committees. These were petitions that our predecessor committee had taken forward as far as they could, or had decided would be best taken forward by a subject committee. By convention, at the end of a parliament, if these matters are still under discussion, the petition is referred back to the petitions committee, because it may well be that the subject committee that was previously considering it is disbanded or is reconstructed in a different form. So we have 15 petitions in that category, and I would like to recommend that we now refer those petitions back to the most appropriate, and it may in some cases be the same, but to the most appropriate subject committee that can take those petitions forward again. Are we content to do that? We are. Thank you all very much. Now, do any members have any other matters that they would like us to consider this morning? Brief as we have been, I think we have covered the immediate items on the agenda. And I will take that as agreement that we have. And so thank you all very much. And we look forward to our first public meeting of the Petitions Committee at the start of the session after the summer recess. Till then, thank you all and good morning.